my exhibit is going to be looking at faces, faces from a whole range of different directions, trying to understand something about how the human brain processes faces, and how, once we understand that, we can start to build interesting new technologies like robots that recognize things like expressions and are able to interact with us in appropriate and sensible and social. When people come to see us at the exhibition, there's going to be a whole range of exciting stuff for them to see and to do. We're going to have a range of illusions based on the way that people perceive and sometimes misperceive faces. We're going to give you a chance to explore something called face space, this strange mathematical concept that allows you to be able to move around, to be able to change your face from a female face to a male face, and allows you to be able to understand something about how human beings possibly represent faces inside our brains. And then finally, a chance to see some of the state-of-the-art technology that we have built for a robots project that I'm involved in that recognizes faces, facial expressions, and uses those to be able to build new technologies that can interact with us in new, exciting, and naturalistic ways. So facial recognition is the ability that human beings have to recognize faces. Actually, about half of your brain has some kind of input from the visual world, and we find it incredibly easy to do. You can recognize your friend from a distance with them wearing a hat that's covering part of their face on a rainy day, perhaps in a slightly dark area with a shadow falling over them. It's incredibly simple for you to recognize faces. It's an incredibly difficult thing for computers to do. It's really very, very hard. And that's why, by trying to understand how the biological system, how your brain actually is able to do this wonderful feat that we all take just for granted, allows us to build these new kinds of technologies that are going to be able to do those sorts of things as well. So what role does the brain actually play in recognizing faces? Well, this is a model of a brain. It's actually about the same size as your brain. The whole of the back of the brain, the area called the visual cortex, is actually processing the information that's coming in through your eyes. It does lots of really clever processing on that, breaking it down into different colours, different orientations and so on. But by the time it gets up to these areas at the side here, they're called the mediotemporal areas, and areas around something called the fusiform gyrus, it begins to actually be able to process forms in particularly exotic and interesting shapes, like those of faces. In fact, there have been some cases where people have had strokes that have destroyed actual parts of their brain. And in particular cases, something called prosopagnosia can happen, where people have a selective inability to recognize familiar faces. And that actually is very damaging to them for their ability to interact socially with one another. They don't recognize friends and family. They don't recognize others who they've seen before, because that part of their brain is actually doing the computation to recognize faces, and face-like structure just isn't working. Developing robots that recognize faces is actually a big research topic worldwide. At the moment, robots tend to be very much mechanical tools that are helping in factories, building cars and so on. But if they're going to be able to help us in more social environments, in the home, in hospitals, to help us in education and entertainment, they need to be able to interact properly with us. And one of the ways that as human beings we interact naturally and constantly with one another is through our facial expressions. So by being able to build systems that recognize facial expressions on human beings, they'll know whether we are happy or sad, because that's the way we express ourselves through our faces. I can act according to the project I'm working on. We're building robot heads that have the ability to express emotions, whatever emotions are in a computer, back towards the human being. And that to and fro, that ability to take into consideration the emotional impact that you're having in those interactions, actually makes for a much better, more efficient way of being able to interact with robots and new types of technology. You see? So this is Pleo, who's a socially aware robot dinosaur. You can interact with him. He's got very rudimentary vision. He can detect light and dark in there, but also is covered with a series of touch sensors. So over a period of time, if you play with him properly, if you interact with him, he starts to make very happy noises. If you're nasty to him, and forgive me, Pleo, for doing this, and hold him up like this, then he tends to get rather upset about it. Sorry. And so by reacting, it's okay, it's okay. So by reacting in a way that we would expect an animal to react, you actually build a very strong social